6 a.m. Heathrow Airport. We are hoping for no travel delays today on the way to Switzerland. Sooner had I recorded that last clip, hoping for no delays today. I walk into the airport. Can't believe I'm about to say this. Walk into the airport, go to check in for my flight. Flight is canceled. Next flight is at 7:30 p.m. Want to know what the time is right now in the a.m.? I'll show you. That's right, folks. 12 and a half hours at Heathrow Airport. But I can't go anywhere. I have to stay here in case they get another plane. And we leave before that. But right now I'm booked on a 7:30 flight. I won't get in until 10. Talking about a solid 12 hour delay. So I think by the time this trip comes to an end, we'll add up all the delays and I would have probably lost a solid 2.5 days. Amazing, but it's Christmas. One great thing about Heathrow is that the United Lounge, I think it's only about a year old. It's huge, it's big, it's got hot food, it's got great Wi-Fi. So I'm gonna head off, do some vlog editing, and hang out for 12 hours. Third lounge of the day, just out of boredom, I think. When I came over here, Singapore Airlines has a quite nice lounge. Although, when you first walk into the Singapore Airlines lounge, it does look like a school cafeteria. And then it develops into these rather nice, kind of first class cubicle, like private work stations, which is really nice. And it means I can have kind of Asian food for lunch. I had the English breakfast at the United Lounge, little mid-morning snack in the Lufthansa Senator Lounge, and now I'm here at the Singapore Airlines Lounge to grab some Asian food for lunch. So at least with a 12-hour delay, there's a lot of stuff you can do at Heathrow Airport. They are well equipped in the lounge department. Fourth and final lounge stop for the day, the Maple Leaf Air Canada Lounge. Very nice. Stopped by and managed to work on the soundtrack for the vlog, which is great. They have these awesome private rooms with reclining chairs and also an amazing view of the tarmac, which was quite inspirational for work, I've got to say. Now I've been here close to 10 hours, about 2 hours away from boarding the flight. I can't wait to get out of here. Okay, I've been at the airport exactly 12 hours and I'm finally getting on the plane. Feels so good.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Geneva.
Made it to Geneva. That means no more flights for 1 week. Just when I thought the hits couldn't keep on coming, I land at Geneva Airport, go to pick up my rental car, go over to the desk, We don't have you in the system, sir. Did you book on the French side or the Swiss side? I said, I don't know, I just booked at Geneva Airport. Okay, well, there are two sides. Okay, well, does it matter? It's the same company? Yeah, it matters, because the side that you booked with called you a no-show, because my flight was canceled and I didn't make it in, no-showed me without contacting me or letting me know that was what they were going to do, canceled my reservation, and then closed for the night about 45 minutes before I did eventually get there. And on the Swiss side, where the same company was still open, quoted me an on-the-spot price of $200 more than my reservation. Amazing. So hopefully this is the last disaster of the week when it comes to travel, because I think I'm just about out of patience at this point. So yeah, I got the car from Hertz in the end, and we're away.